there's about 39 million people in the world who are blind. 90% of those are living in countries like Kenya.
Yes?
80% of them are blind from diseases that we already know how to cure or prevent.
Can everybody write all you can see on the blackboard?
I still can't believe we're in a world where we've already worked out how to provide most of the treatment, and it's still not happening. That felt deeply unfair. I made a decision in my late teens that I wanted to become an eye surgeon. Growing up in the UK, I felt both angry and guilty for having what I did have and for other people not having it. 2012, my wife and my son and I moved to Kenya to give something back. Most of the resources for eye care are in big towns and cities. Most of the patients who need access to that are out in more rural areas. So you have this big gap between where provision is and where people who need it are. One of the options is you take the equipment to the community, and that's what we tried to do. All of this heavy, very sensitive equipment, over £100,000 worth of kit, and a team of 15 people, putting it in the back of a van, going on non-tarmac roads to places with no electricity. The impact we were having was still very, very small, and something was going to have to change. Then I thought, it must be possible to recreate all of these tests I'm doing in the clinic, but doing it on a smartphone. Vision testing in itself is quite complex. The idea is to simplify the process so much that anyone can do the test. So in 2 to 3 minutes, I can teach you how to deliver this test anywhere on anyone. And this device here allows you to look inside the eye with the phone. And look how sharp the detail is. That was maybe 30 seconds, and he's already now getting a view of the retina. We don't think of ourselves as a technology company. Everything that we do is built on good people. Teachers in schools, healthcare workers out in the community, they can use a test which will provide accurate, reliable, objective results and share that with the specialist who can make the decision as to whether or not they need to come for treatment. Brian and his grandmother live, just the two of them together, and are completely dependent on one another, yet neither of them can see. The leading cause of blindness is cataract. By putting an artificial lens in, you can restore sight overnight.
How many fingers?
That's
good. They're able to see. They'll be able to see their children, their animals. Today they are going home, they'll see the food they're eating.
There'll always be more to do. We've had requests that would amount to 10 million children being screened if we had the capacity to deliver that. So we're setting out now to put up a building near the eye unit where people from all over the world can come to learn how to run the programs and take that into the communities that they're working in. The thing that keeps me up at night is knowing there's still queues of patients everywhere. I want to see that change.